Good morning, everyone. Welcome back. In the previous class, we studied about the operators and operands. Then we studied the types of operators. We saw that depending on the number of operands required, the operators are divided into three categories: unary operators, binary operators, and ternary operators. And again, in the unary operators, we studied the unary plus, unary minus, unary plus plus, which is the increment operator, and the unary minus minus operator. Later on, we saw the differences between unary plus plus when it is used as a prefix and unary plus plus when it is used as a postfix. Similarly for the minus minus, that is decrement operators also. And today we are going to see about the types of binary operators. What are binary operators? Binary operators are the operators which are requiring at least two operands. There are few binary operators. We can classify them: binary arithmetical operators, relational operators, logical operators, etc. Let's see now the arithmetical operators, which are of the binary nature. Okay. Plus, minus, multiplication, division, and modulus. These are the five arithmetical operators of Java. The first one is the one which is very common, which we are using in the mathematics to add two numbers or to find out sum of few numbers or two numbers. Let's see with one example. Sum is equal to A plus B, where A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 10. Okay, so what happens? A is 3, B is 10. They are added together and the sum will be stored on the left hand side. Since on the left side of this operator we have one operand, and the right side also we have one operand, we call them as binary operand because it requires two operands. Okay, this binary arithmetical operator, the plus symbol, can operate with the byte, short, int, long, character, float. It can work with almost all the primitive data types except Boolean. Okay, so if we give sum is equal to 3.2 plus 4.8, it can be done. Or we are using x is equal to 3.2, y is equal to 2.1, then we can give double sum is equal to x plus y. They can add a fractional values also. So that is about the binary arithmetical operator, which is the plus. Now let's see the symbol which is used for finding the difference, the minus operator. Suppose we have a difference is equal to A minus B with the previous example. A is 3, B is 10, the result will become as minus 7. They will store the difference between them. Suppose you give difference 1 is equal to B minus A, where B was 10 and A was 3, the result will become as 7. Similarly, we can have a subtraction between the double data type, float data type, I mean fraction values. See this example. We are given difference 2 is equal to x minus y. 3.2, that is 3.2 minus 2.1, which is equal to 1.1. I think it is clear. Okay, next we will proceed to the multiplication, which is used to find the product of two numbers. Yeah, one thing I would like to say about the difference or the subtraction operator, which is our minus symbol. It can have all the primitive data types like byte, short, int, long. Then we can have a float as well as the double. Now we proceed to the multiplication, which is used to find product of two numbers. Let's see. Yeah, we have A with the 10 and B with the 3. We are creating a variable int prod is equal to A multiplied by B. A was 10, B is 3, 10 into 3, 30 will come to the left side. Similarly, we can have the fractional values also for the multiplication. We are given double prod 1 is equal to 2.2 into 2. What will be the result? 4. That means the multiplication operator can work upon all the integer data types, byte, short, int, log, as well as the fractional data types. I think it's clear. Again, we have the division symbol, which is used to get the quotient after the division. Suppose we have A with 10, B with 3. We have to get the quotient, you know. So we are giving Q is equal to A divided by B. What is the value of A? 10. And B is 3. So when we divide it, 10 divided by 3, if Q is double in nature, if it is double in nature, the result may go 3.33, etc. And if it is integer in nature, if the operators are integer, example, int x is equal to 10 and int y is equal to 2. If both the operands are integer, then our result R is equal to, the result is equal to x by y. The value will be 10 divided by 2, which is 5. Now let's see where we are having fractional values. We are having double P is equal to 4.4 and double Q is equal to 2.2. Then we are giving double R is equal to P divided by Q. 4.4 divided by 2.2, the R will be 2.0. The result will be 2.0. That is, this division operator can work with integers as well as fractional data types. Okay? Now, if we have another value, P is equal to minus 4.4 and Q is equal to 2, our result will be minus 2.2. Our result will be minus 2.2. One is minus, this is minus, result is minus. Minus 2.2 into 2 is equal to minus 4.4. I think what I told is clear. Okay. Now, we have a different operator which is given here and it is known as modulus operator. The modulus operator is used to get the remainder after the division. When two numbers are divided, if there is any remainder, that remainder we have to get back. Then we are using the modulus operator. Let's see. Already we have written A equal to 10 and B is 3. We are going to write R is equal to A by B, A modulus B. Then the result will be 1. Reason is the 3 will go 3 times in 10, means as a whole we can take out 3 times from 10, and what is left out? 1 is left out. Okay, again we have a double x is equal to 4.7 and a double y is equal to 2.3. Then we are dividing it. Double R is equal to, R is equal to X modulus Y. What will be the result? Let's see. 4.7 is divided by 2.3. 2 times it can go in 4.7 as a whole. The remainder will be 0.5. So, we can say that this modulus operator can work with integers as well as double and float. I think all these 5 arithmetical operators are clear. Okay, now I just want to tell you about the nature of plus operator with the strings. I told you this plus operator can work with byte, short, int, long, char, then double as well as float. But what about the strings? What will happen when we use this plus symbol with the strings? That is what we are going to see. Suppose we have 5.5 plus 2 in string. both are strings because they are enclosed in double quotation. We are adding them. The result will be 52. What is happening? Both of them have joined together, concatenated. We got 52. Again, we have 5 plus 2. One is string, other one is numeric. Same will happen, 52. Reason is, when one is string, the other one also will be automatically converted to string, and we got it as 52. Suppose we give 5 plus 2 without any quotation. You know, it is 7. Doing the arithmetical calculation, we are getting the sum of them. Okay, next. We have system.out.println. Sum is plus 5 plus 2. We are going to add 5 plus 2 and going to print with the message. What is going to happen? The result will be printed as sum is 52. Oh, we wanted to print it as sum is 7, but the result is coming as sum is 52. The reason is, since the first one was a string, the others also are converted to string, so we got it as sum is 52, that means they are concatenated. But we wanted to have 7, then what should have given? We should have written it as SOPLN sum is within the double quotation plus 5 plus 2 should have given in the bracket, so that we get it as sum is 7. I think it is clear. So just have a note of this plus symbol with the strings, because sometimes they are asked in the examinations for getting the output. What will be the output of the following code? Such kind of questions may come. So please look into that. Okay? Thank you.